Okay, children, after our grammar part, we are going to deal with our writing skills, which is a very important part of your in high class standards or higher classes, which comes under major and minor discourse. In your exam, okay, so mostly up to 8th class, you get this for 12 and 8 marks. When you come to 9th and 10th, you come across of 10 and 5. And major discourses are divided into 10 and minor discourses for 5 marks. So, diary entry. Here, the writing skills we have going to learn about diary entry. So, it's an informal writing. Okay, then what is formal? Actually, we have formal and informal writing. Both formal and informal. When it is about the formal, we follow rules, regulation. Here formal is written to someone superior or in higher authority. No, it's never meant to be something impersonal. That is called formal. When we write formal, we maintain so many rules, regulation when we write something. A kind of letter writing or official writing, what you call it as. Informal writing, where it is about personal. We don't follow many kind of rules, only very few things we have to keep in our mind. That is the difference between formal and informal. So we are diary entry was for informal writing. So not too many rules or regulation we follow. So what before going to the rules or regulation, let's see what is actually diary entry. Diary entry is a kind of informal writing. Basically, we keep in our personal activity. So even we can maintain, every person can maintain a diary entry where our feelings, our emotions, day to day, something special or something which we cannot do, we share. We write it. People, many people have this habit of writing a diary. I have my personal diary, they say, yes, where a special account of our feelings, special things, special occasions, special moments. will. What is called as the signature. So these are the format. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 is the main part. If you keep in your mind when you write a diary, it will. As it is an informal writing, but it is included in our syllabus, which gives us mark. So each part has this marking. So forgetting any of the part would delete your mark. You may say, well, it is teachers and it's informal writing. It's just a personal thing. Why? Why? Yes, but it is considered in our syllabus, which gives us marks. So we must know the correct way of representing, though it is informal. Though it is informal, as I said, formal or informal? Follows, maybe formal follows little more rules and informal follows little less rules. Okay. So coming here, informal writing, it gives where you will fill less rules, but format is there for everything. So here, what are the points before writing? You have to keep in your mind what it is to. You have to be careful while writing a diary entry. As I said, diary entry is included in your syllabus for marks you are writing. Okay. When you write in your worst study, that different, but when you keep it, when you keep it for your paper for marks, that really should follow some rules. Okay. Written in first person, always I. Whoever, maybe when it is given you as a question, you are imagine you are someone. Imagine you are English teacher of your class. Okay, and you have to that is the first day of your class. Write your experience. How would it be? You have to think as myself of you. Yes or no? Then you will become me there. You can't write your name. You can't write my name over there. You have to write as I. Always first person. What is the first person here? I. Okay. So here, write as you have been really a part. As I said, imagining. Always when you write for yourself, it is your real account or your real encounter with that thing or real experience. But here what you want to write, you have to really imagining. Okay, you have to imagine a teacher, your English teacher came, you have become an English teacher and you entered a class, your first day in that class you have to write. So imagining how it could be. Oh, your imagination, everything depends upon your creativity. The next part, creative imagination and expression. Creative, how creative you can do, what kind of words you can use, how you can make it really, stories you can make, how creative you can with your beautiful words, how you can describe it in a beautiful way, as real English is a very beautiful language, because in one sentence, when you use it many expressions, it gives us different meanings. So here, using your creativity, imagination and expression, that means your emotion, real emotions, how you have to really relate to that situation to write this. Totally depends upon your feelings, how you relate to the question. Okay, so let's say suppose, if here, if I put the, if I suppose this, here this is your page. Okay, so here you are starting your day, your day here. Okay, here your time, then you give a little gap here, space, then you start your salutation. Dear diary, both D are in capital letter, comma, and here your heading, what you call the third part, the heading here. Then after that, from the margin, you start your content. Okay. Suppose your content you finish. After give a space here. Then what do you do? After that, your signature here. Okay. So this should be your representation of this part. I hope you understand this clearly. How to represent it on a paper. So you have a question in your writing skill. Regarding that August filament, depending upon this, right?